television recently, the strong male characters of the shows like The Sopranos and Mad Men have been replaced now by even stronger female characters.
Which is great, and that's also the case with the WGN America show Salem. Our Tom Meany found out why women are the key to the show's success.
Well, you know, you got to keep it fresh, especially right. when it comes to TV. You got to be out there on the leading edge, and that's mm-hmm. the idea with the new television shows, to be one step ahead. And the trend now towards very strong female characters. Our parent company, Tribune, which owns WGN America, is getting ahead of the curve as well and showing how powerful female characters are in Salem.
Witch!
In Salem, Captain John Alden is the hero, but it's Mary Sibley who is a main focus of the show, the tortured woman whose love turns to revenge.
This is my vow. I will come back for you.
When John Alden, her lover, who she thought was dead, returns, it turns her world upside down. You know, but she's kind of created a prison for herself.
The character of Mary Sibley goes through a huge change in the pilot of WGN America's Salem. A change that makes her one of the strongest characters on the show.
I think it's very smart of the writers and WGN to go that angle with the show, because if you look at the shows that are successful, a lot of them have very strong female characters, and there's a new wave, especially in television and in movies as well, of these very strong female characters, and people aren't afraid to show them anymore.
Janet Montgomery's portrayal of Mary Sibley on Salem puts her on par with some of the great power characters on television.
Guys have been doing that for years.
All right.
Like, we can show that. We can show a woman not being nice on TV and in film.
I'm not afraid of the dead. Or the living, for that matter.
That's because you know nothing of death. And less of life.
Being a free thinker was dangerous at that time, certainly in that town, certainly as a woman as well.
Tamsin Merchant plays Anne Hale on Salem. Her free thinking does get her in trouble, but it's another strong female character, along with Elise Eberle, who plays Mercy Lewis.
Because she's the Reverend's daughter, I think it makes sense why evil would want to use her as a way of creating hysteria, because she's that pure girl who wouldn't want to cause hysteria like that.
Mercy is another historically accurate character from Salem, one of the most vocal accusers of witches in the real Salem and on the show. But it's Mary Sibley's dealings with the male characters on Salem that led show creators to almost call the show Mary Sibley.
She's a victim of the male oppression when the show starts. And by the time the show's over, you realize she's running everything. But at what cost emotionally?
You told me he was dead.
It's not like counting sheep, honey. More like counting shadows.
Mary's struggle with love, revenge, and her rise to power begins Sunday in Salem.
And as we count down the days to Salem's debut, we have several web extras for you to check out, from our Salem Fact or Fiction quiz to behind-the-scenes snapshots. Head over to Fox8.com, click on Salem under Quick Links. Salem premieres this Sunday, April 20th, 10 p.m. on WGN America.
Way to go, ladies. I mean, they're great actresses to pull off something like that. I mean.
Yeah. Yeah, they really are. It's a good cast, and even the guy characters are strong as well, but it's really more kind of focused on the women.
The ladies, yeah. I can see that. That's a good thing.
Because it was very puritanical times, you know, where it was a male-dominated society, you know, with all the religion and the priests that were there. But so to work the females into that is going to be an interesting twist.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Yeah. Da-da-da-da.
Da-da.
Thank you, Todd.
You got it.